In this video tech tip, I'd like to go over how to use the mesh modeling tools in SOLIDWORKS to get surfaces from scan data. Here we have some scan data that's a little bit incomplete, and so we're trying to be able to get things and surfaces inside of this model so that we can reverse engineer this wheel a bit more easily. The way that we'll go about this is using the surface from mesh tool. We can choose planar, spherical, cylindrical, or conical surfaces that are mesh data, and then use selection tools, whether selecting individual mesh faces or using the painter tool, to be able to quickly grab and select, in this case, a cylindrical surface. And what SOLIDWORKS is going to do is take this sort of painted mesh and convert it into a cylindrical surface that we can actually use in operations inside of SOLIDWORKS. The painter tool can be adjusted for different types of tolerances, and the size can also be adjusted in a separate window that will pop up as soon as you start painting. But the general idea is you want to be able to get as much of the mesh as possible without picking any sort of faces that would make this not a cylinder. Here you can see how we can change the size, selecting OK to do the operation, and then hitting Calculate will calculate a surface from this. When we hit OK, we'll unpin this operation, and we can see we have a new surface available to us that is not mesh as indicated by the feature tree. Isolating this, you can see that we now have a cylindrical surface. So this is just one way to be able to get surfaces. For items that are less prismatic than this, you may want to consider something like GeoMagic for SOLIDWORKS. From this, we can now create reference geometry to further reverse engineer this project.